The last words of Dr. Edward Mantell, a physicist at CERN. On July 13, 2016, a CERN researcher was found dead in his office from a self-inflicted gunshot wound. The renowned scientist had been researching what he called a hidden code of sorts in the movement of neutrinos from the north to the south magnetic poles. His colleagues said he hadn't slept for days after he allegedly gave up on his research. He shut himself in his office, and after a couple days of not appearing in his lab or at his regular appointments, his state was discovered. He had burned all of his research in his trash bin, and his computer had been wiped of all data except one text file. Upon discovery, the document was classified but has since been leaked to the public by someone of yet unknown origin. It is assumed to be the final product of his research. This is a transcript of said document. If you're reading this, then I have failed. The LHC at CERN is capable of far more than they tell the public. Two of the most impressive experiments that has taken place at CERN, we have found a way to look at people, places, and things much like looking in a mirror. We have decoded part of the mysteries of time travel. A person can jump, as they call it, to another person or object in time. We have also found out that we can't stop something that has happened or will happen, only delay the event. Each delay pushes an event forward for 3 years. Don't ask me why 3 years, everything happens in threes. On April 29, 2016, the Large Hadron Collider was about to increase their power so high a high-energy collision inside the LHC would have created the first experimental evidence of Hawking radiation, the only radiation predicted to be emitted from a black hole's event horizon. 2 days later, a supermassive black hole formed. 3 days later, the Earth was gone. I saw this happen in the mirror experiments. I thought of my family, my friends, then I decided I needed to jump, do something to save them. Earlier this year, a friend of the family gave me a grown offspring of Felicia the ferret, who is somewhat of a low-key celebrity in the physics community, was used to help physicists clean 300-foot pipes in particle accelerators at Fermilab, a particle physics laboratory in Illinois. Felicia. So my friends, if this worked, a headline should read: the most powerful machine on Earth was just halted by a tiny weasel. You should have another 3 years. Now I leave, but I also leave you with this. Life. Why is it so sacred? Has it been elevated to a mythical status with the onset of modern intelligence? Or, has modern intelligence caused you to come to the rational conclusion that life is but a mere commodity, one that gives nothing but advancements towards the greater good of a species that is doomed to die out as all species are? Is life without intelligence really life? Can intelligence and consciousness be separated into two distinct pools? A hive mind can be intelligent without consciousness.